Now let's start our another topic. Last time we have talked about histogram equalization, and today we will see the topic of histogram specification. This is also known as either specification or sometimes we tell histogram matching. I have explained you one important point during histogram equalization, that histogram equalizations we basically perform over whole image, but sometimes our region of interest is not a complete, you can say, image or all the pixels in the image. Sometimes we try, because whenever you are trying to do histogram equalization of any given image, let's say image was darkened in nature, then how basically you will be getting? Basically, you will be getting, after histogram, you will be getting a flat kind of graph. Fine. So whatever kind of histogram is given to you, either darker or brighter or something like that, after equalization operations, you always get a flat kind of histogram, a unique flat kind of histogram. But sometimes you do not always want this kind of graphs. Reason being, even if you have got flat kind of graph, somewhere you may not be getting a good image kind of things, because we have seen in so many examples also, once you are applying histogram equalization over a given image, and if you are getting an equalized gray labels, sometimes they may be concentrating into a particular range only. Not you are, although their number of pixels are more or less same or particular gray label, but your image is not spread uniformly over all gray scales or gray label of input output image. So in such situations, sometimes you always try to convert your input image not in a form of flat image, rather than you try to manipulate your input image with a given reference image, or you can say with a given reference histogram of an image. So let's say I have this kind of let's say input image, and another input image or histogram is given like this. So what is our objective? Our objective is to convert this histogram using the reference of another image into a different kind of, you can say, image representation. So that is known as histogram matching. Histogram matching means you are matching your source image, source input image, with a given target image. You are matching your source input image with the target image, and you are converting that histogram of input image based on the target histogram of given image. So that's the reason that is known as referencing also. Reference histogram is always given to you, and that is known as histogram specification or histogram matching. So you have histogram H1 and then you have histogram S2 of your target image, and you are trying to equalize. You are trying to equalize histogram of H1 by using the reference from S2 histogram label. So if you are using this kind of operation, this is known as histogram matching or histogram specification. So today we will see how to do that given histogram of two different images. So the major goal of histogram matching, major goal of histogram matching is to take an input image and generate an output image that is based upon the shape of specific histogram, shape of specific reference histogram. You'll be getting an output image from an input image based on reference from an specific target image. That is the meaning of histogram matching. Now let's take this question. Modify histogram A as given by histogram B. So this is nothing. This is the same as histogram specification or histogram matching. You are trying to convert input image A as a source image given as a target image, as a reference image. So two histogram is given to you. You need to convert histogram A by using histogram of B image. So process will be same as we have done in histogram equalization. So step number one will be same. We will do what? First of all, we will draw the table for histogram A as well as for table for histogram B. Table, what table? The table that we have drawn during histogram equalization, where we have mentioned about probability density function, cumulative density function, SK multiplied by number of bits, highest representation, that is SK into 7, and then getting our approx or equalized histogram label. And in last column, last time if you remember, I have told you to find out the probability density function of SK. During that, what we are doing? We are clubbing the number of pixels representing that particular equalized histogram label. So that one more column you need to draw for image 1 and image 2, let's say. Clear? So same way that we have done in last time, histogram equalization, histogram matching also, we will follow the same process. So let's see what the table of A and table of B results us. So first of all, we will find out the equalized histogram of our source input image. So this is the solution for source input image. So it's the same as we have done last time. First of all, we will represent our gray label. Second column, we will represent the number of pixels on each and every gray label. Then we will try to find out PDF. PDF is nothing. NK over MN. MN is total number of pixels in my image. So same way it is given in the questions. So we have calculated PDF of this divided by size of my image. And then cumulative distribution functions is nothing, just summation of its earlier value as we have done in the histogram equalization. And the next column is same, SK into 7. And then finally we are finding out round off value. The round off value we are finding out here. And then only one new thing we are doing here, as explained in my last video also, we are trying to find out our new NK or new PDF of SK. So new NK is nothing, the number of pixels which are representing this equalized label now. Now this one is represented by same, 3 is represented by same number of pixels, 5 will be corresponding to 850. But these two round of value, obtained equalized label 6, is representing how many number of pixels in original image? It is representing 656 plus 329. So in our equalized image, converted image, you can say, you have how many number of pixels representing this? 985. So 985 will be new NK for equalized label 6. Similarly, for equalized label 7, you will have this 3 summation of pixels. So from this table, new NK is a new entry only you are getting apart from what you have done in histogram equalization. There we are simply either stopping process here, or even if you are trying to find out, we try to find out PDF. So PDF is nothing, it's a new NK divided by MN. So 985 divided by 4096, you will get PDF here. Similarly here, 0.19. But rather than writing PDF here, you are writing here number of new NK. So from this, whenever you are trying to, now you are trying to convert this input image given a reference image. So given a reference image was our image B. So from this table, what thing you require whenever you are trying to convert this input image by using reference image. So similarly for reference image also for image B, we will solve the same thing, but till this point only, till this column. So for equalized histogram of B, we will try to find out till round off. We will not try to find out new NK value. But for source image, you need to remember, you need to find out NK value also, which is nothing but summation of its original number of pixels if it is representing the same gray label in equalized histogram. So that's important. From this table, only we are going to take two things. What we are going to take two things? Simply new NK value is a new things and gray label. Only two things we are going to, last column and second last column. Only two things we are going to, round off value along with its new NK value. These two things we are going to take whenever we are converting this image into a reference image. By using that reference image, we are trying to specify our input image. So let's see the solution for equalize histogram B and what column you require from there we will take, and then we will convert input image by using the column of equalized reference image. Now let's see the equalized histogram solution for target image B. Same we have done for A, similarly we have done for B. NK, PDF, CDF, SK multiplied by 7 and then getting its round off equalized label. From this table A, from this table B, which is our target image, we will be taking two columns. The column number 1, that is gray label, and last column that we are getting round off. These two columns from target image you have to take. In the target image, you never try to find out NK or new NK, you can say. Fine. So target image table will get stopped in round off column. While in source image, you will add one more column, that is new NK, which you will obtain by adding the summation of similar kind of round off value if you are obtaining here. So now we have to match input image with our target image. So we will be taking these two columns from this table and this column and next column from our input converted equalized label table from figure A. So let's take these two things from here and last two columns from first equalize histogram A. Then we will try to match how to convert an input image A using this reference image B. So now see, if you take first and last column of B, you will get this first column wall representing gray label and last column wall representing round off equalized label of histogram. And if you are taking last two column of A table, it was round off equalized label and new NK value. What is our objective? To convert this input image using the reference of B. So here something like inverse transformations kind of activity we are doing here. Inverse transformation kind of activity we are doing here. That is what? We are trying to retrieve the number of pixels. We are trying to present the number of pixels in the resultant image by using the gray labels of reference images. Clear? So gray label of reference image, let's say 0 is representing 0 and no mapping is there. 2 is also representing 0. Now gray label of reference image is 3, is rounded off to 1. Now this 1 will be mapped with round off value of my source, and we will try to check how many number of pixels in new NK of that source image is representing. So that is representing by 790. So if you plot it, you will get like this. You will get like this. On 0, let's say no pixel. On 1, you will have no pixel. On 2, you will have no pixel. But on 3, but on gray label 3 of your resultant image, how many number of pixels it will represent? It will represent to round off value corresponding to input image, and round off value mapping to corresponding to input image was 790. So resultant image having reference image gray label 3 will be represented with 790 pixels. Similarly for 3 will be representing what? We will be representing, so for 3 we will be representing 790. Similarly for gray label, next gray label is 4. So take next 4 gray label. 4 gray label is corresponding to round off to 3, and 3 is mapped to 3 here. Nearest same mapping we are getting. One point you try to understand here. If you are getting same mapping, no issue, just map with this. If you are not getting exact mapping, let's say here the value is 3 and here there is no 3 round off value you have in your input image. Then what is the process? Process is like this. You try to map with nearest round off value. So we will never go to the next highest label. We will always try to go to the lowest nearest value. So let's say 3 is there and there was no 3. Same example you can take. Then we will try to map 3 with 1. Okay. And let's say if there is 2, then 3 will be mapped with 2, not with 1. Clear? 3 will either be mapped with corresponding 3 or it will be mapped with nearest lower label matching and corresponding pixel will be represented for that particular grayscale. But that is not the case here. Here 3 is mapped exactly with 3. So 4 gray label of resultant image will be having how many pixels? 1023. Similarly for 5. 5 will be matched with 5. How many number of pixels? 850. So 5 will be represented with 850. Similarly for 6. 6 will be represented with now 985. 6 will be represented with now 985. So it's 985. And similarly 7. 7 will be represented as 448. So this is the kind of resultant image you will be getting if you are using or matching with the reference image of B. Two important points. I have told you only two things you need to remember. In your original source image, you need to take last two column. In your reference image, you have to take first column and last column of round off value. And nothing beyond that. Now you take these two column. Try to map it. Try to map it with the round off value here. With this round off value, if same matching you are getting, fine, simply represent by total number of pixels of new NK value in your resultant manipulated image. But let's say if you are not getting the same value, you always try to match with nearest round off value and its corresponding pixel representation. That's all for histogram matching or histogram specification. We will take up one more question and let's see what is the solution of that question.